Hey, it's LSFT here today, and today we're here to look at the Lexus mobile app. Actually just got an update. You can see what's been improved here. It actually says here that the map view of charge station and guest drivers. And then the biggest thing I want to talk about today is the digital key refinements. What does that really mean? I don't know. So the only way for me to know is to try and see if I can get my Pixel 6 Pro to work with the digital key, or if there's any improvements at all. So let's give that a try and see what happens. So now we're back to the Lexus Connected Technology Support website on the NX2450H Plus 2022, actually 2023 will be the same. When you look at this, the digital key, I have a few viewers who have actually reached out to me saying that, oh, I cannot download the key, or I cannot get, like after the key goes onto the start button, it beeps twice and nothing happens. So here's a few tips. One thing that I've noticed myself is that on my iPhone, when I changed over to the iPhone 14, I was not able to download the key. So here is a few tips that they've provided. For download, they're saying that you may experience issues, errors when you download the key. So what do you do? They're telling you to force quit the app, make sure there's only one connection, either using Wi-Fi or mobile, and then you go and download the key again. If the connection is configured and download fails, then they're telling you to wait 3 minutes to reattempt downloading the key. So I think what happens is if it fails, you probably will not be able to do it until the system resets and gets you a new key. How I solved it was I actually uninstalled the Lexus app, reinstalled it, re-signed in, and everything started to work properly. And the next thing is, when you actually put your key fob onto the start button, it beeps twice and nothing happens. So what do? So it'll say unable to pair your digital key. And one reason is, it's because you've attempted a few times and the phone has actually registered car digital key as the Bluetooth. So when you put your key over the start button, it beeps twice. But because your phone actually has the car digital key already, it wouldn't pop up the message telling you to pair. So what you need to do is you go into your phone settings, remove the car digital key. Once that is removed, you try it again, then your phone will actually pop up and tell you that, oh, you need to pair with the car digital key. Once that is done, hopefully you've successfully registered your digital key. So now we go back and I was looking at the smartphone compatibility. So in my previous digital key video, I went to the same website and it actually said that the digital key was not compatible with my Google 6 Pro. So now when I go into here, notice that Lexus has actually updated the compatibility. So I'm going to go here and select Google 6 Pro. And now you can see here that the digital key is now green, which means it is compatible. So that would be a very good opportunity now to see if the digital key actually works better or not. Let me just go here one more time and just double check the new iPhones and see if it has actually been updated that the iPhone 14 actually is compatible too. So we see iPhone 14. So everything seems, oh. So now the digital key is a question mark. So which means they haven't tested it yet. But I can tell you, I've tested it myself and it's compatible. So right now I'm in my garage and trying to use my Google 6 Pro to lock and unlock and try the digital key. You will notice that first attempt it failed. I reopened the door, locked it again, and it worked. Now I try to open it, and it doesn't open. It does not recognize the digital key. After several attempts, it seemed to work. It seems to be a bit delayed. I lock it again, and unfortunately, it does not work again. It gets very frustrating if you're actually using it. I try on the back door, open it again, lock it again, and it worked. Ain't that funny? So I've shown now how it doesn't work in the outside. It seems to work, but not always. So now I'm in the vehicle, trying to start the car. It says key not detected. So the car doesn't know that the phone's actually in the car yet. So I tried it again, it still continues to say key not detected. So I'm just gonna wait a little bit longer and unlock the phone, have it in the Lexus app, press it again, and this time, it actually worked. Isn't that interesting? So it does look like it takes a little longer for the phone to tell the car I'm in the car, and then that will work. My next thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to power off the car and then get out and try to lock the door. That's what we do day to day when we drive the vehicle, right? And it should work seamlessly. It shouldn't be anything different from the key fob. So let's see. I open the door, gonna close the door, and lock. Oops. Nope. Doesn't work. And I can see it says vehicle detects the key in the car. So I open the door, go back in, and you can see in the display, it'll say key detected in vehicle. With the latest Lexus app update, I did notice that downloading the digital key was faster and more consistent. I think I've downloaded the digital key way more times than most of you, as I have been deleting the key, re-registering the key, and doing a lot of this while filming these videos. I got to admit that downloading the digital key was much more reliable, and setting up the key was also improved. However, on the Google Pixel 6 Pro, it still doesn't replace the key fob. It is slow to recognize the phone is not in the vehicle, and is also slow to recognize that it's in the vehicle. I really hope that the app update and the stamp of compatibility on their website would have meant that it would work as it should. I have no choice but to delete the key from my Android device, as it causes conflicts when I use the key fob. I just can't lock the car. My next video in relation to the digital key is that I will be using my iPhone 14 Pro as the digital key for a day to see if it can replace the key fob. And will I have confidence of leaving the key fob at home and just relying on my iPhone? Thanks for watching. Thank you for watching. If you like this video, please comment, like, and share this video. If you'd like to see more videos like this, you can subscribe to my channel and press that alert button to get notified when new videos are posted. If you'd like to support the channel, you can definitely provide a super thanks. I'll see you guys again next time in the next video.